Good morning, friends. In previous class, we already calculated the radius of the electron in nth orbit. That value is equal to, I am writing here to recall here. So I am writing Rn is equal to, that is the radius of the nth orbit in a hydrogen atom is equal to n square h square epsilon naught, n square h square epsilon naught divided by pi m E square. This is the radius of the electron in nth orbit. So this is already we calculated. If you did not understand this value, you can go through the last video what we uploaded. So that is the Rn value. Now the present question is, what is the velocity of the electron in the nth orbit? We need to go find out this one. According to the Bohr's theory, we are already known the electron, so that is the electron, the third equation, what is the Bohr's theory will tell that mvr is equal to, so the angular velocity mvr is equal to, according to Bohr theory, n h by 2 pi, this is the value. We need to go find out this v value, where v is equal to n h by 2 pi into mr. Where is the, if we want to find out the Vn, velocity of the orbit in nth orbit is equal to radius of the electron in nth orbit. So I am substituting this Rn value, which is already derived in the previous topic. I am substituting here. Therefore, velocity of the electron in nth orbit Vn is equal to nh divided by 2 pi m into Rn. Rn value on substituting, so it is in denominator term, so n square h square pi epsilon naught denominator will come, so n square h square epsilon naught, if write in denominator one more time, it will come numerator position pi m e square. So the, so if you see the same values which is having, we can cancel to each other, m value will cancel. So remaining n value, n square, n value cancel, h square, h will cancel, the pi is cancelled. Now what is the remaining terms we are having? Velocity of the electron in nth orbit is equal to e square divided by 2 into 2n h epsilon naught. This is the value we got, velocity of the electron in nth orbit. So in this equation we can easily find out, so E is the constant term, H is the constant term, epsilon naught is the constant term. This value already told you in the previous class. If you substitute that values, you can easily find out the velocity of the electron in nth orbit. So we can simply substitute these all values. If you substitute these all values, you will get like this, Vn is equal to 2.8 into 10 to the power of 6 meter per second divided by n value. You will get the value. This is the velocity of the electron in nth orbit. Velocity of the electron in nth orbit. So the value of the Vn is equal to, then we can easily find out this value. We can, with help of this one, velocity of the electron in nth orbit is inversely proportional to the electron. It is the number of the, this is the orbital number. So if you go to the orbital number is increasing, velocity will decrease. You can easily find out this value. So if you go to the smallest orbital, now I am taking smallest orbital, this is the biggest orbital, that is the first orbital. If it is the n is equal to 1, first orbital, n is equal to 2, second orbital. According to the velocity of the orbital, so if you go to near to the nucleus, the electron will rotate with a larger velocity. If you go to the further more distance, the electron will revolve with a less velocity as per the equation. Why the electron is moving more velocity means the electron tries to escape from the nucleus source, it should be run with more velocity. If the further distance will go, the electron will have the less nuclear force, it will run with less velocity also. This is the equation we derived. This is the Bohr's equation. Bohr's velocity equation in the hydrogen atom.